दोस्तों, इस क्लास में मैं आपको डिक्टेशन दूंगा उसी मैटर की जो पिछली क्लास में आपको मैंने 80 WPM पर प्रोवाइड किया था। ग्रेड डी का मैटर है और 100 WPM पर आपको डिक्टेशन दे रहा हूं। बी रेडी फॉर इट। अ वन ऑफ द मेथड्स ही हैज चूजन इज टू लाइट द लैंप ऑफ एडुकेशन। द सेटिंग अप ऑफ साधु वाश्वनी स्कूल्स इन डिफरेंट लोकेशंस ऑफ द कंट्री is a part of his journey. This is a commendable achievement, and this is the rich and purposeful legacy that strengthens the very foundations of the school. Ladies and gentlemen and dear children, your school is doubly blessed. It draws motivation from not just Sadhu Vashwani and Dada J.P. Vashwani, but also from the inspiring history of Pune. The city of Pune has been a center of education for Maharashtra and for the country. The story of modern India owes much to the educational, reformist and progressive ideas that have flowed from this city and for which our nation is truly appreciative. It was in this city that in 1848 was opened what is believed to have been the first modern school in India exclusively for girls. Education was their chief weapon in their determined efforts to fight caste and gender discrimination and work for the weaker sections. They were not alone. It was in Pune that the Maharashtra Girls Education Society was set up in the 19th century. Many of these initiatives and educational institutions are still with us and are still going strong. In Maharashtra and in other states, they are responsible for schools and colleges that prepare our children and our younger generation for service to the nation and for service to society. The chief architect of our constitution, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, had a long relationship with Pune. He too stressed the importance of education as an instrument for social change and for building a just and egalitarian society. I am happy to learn that the government of Maharashtra has begun to celebrate November 7 as Students' Day. This was the day way back in the year 1900 when Baba Saheb Ambedkar enrolled in a school in Satara and began his lifelong pursuit of academic excellence. Values-based education helps promote ethics in society. I can think of no better example as an upholder of values in our public life than Shri Lal Krishna Advani, who we are honored to have here with us today. I am delighted to be here this morning to review the passing out parade of the 134th course of the National Defence Academy. I must congratulate the cadets on their disciplined drill and perfect turnout. This is a sight to behold, a sight that reflects the glory and pride of our nation. As the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, this is a moment of immense satisfaction for me. The Armed Forces are a symbol of excellence and dedication for the entire country. This parade comprises cadets from all parts of India and from a variety of communities. Its harmony speaks for our essential unity as much as for our pluralism as a society. A soldier or an officer in uniform, irrespective of whether he or she is from the Army, the Navy, or the Air Force, evokes admiration and trust everywhere in the country. If a fellow citizen sees a member of the armed forces at a railway station or a market or at any other place, there is an immediate emotion of pride and reassurance. This is due to the unparalleled and unquestioning service to the nation in times of war and peace, on the border or within the country, during a natural calamity. The armed forces represent the best of the Indian ethos. I am confident that these values have been imbibed by the cadets who are graduating today. I have strongly identified with the armed forces ever since I became the President of India. My first visit outside Delhi after taking office was to Ladakh to be with brave soldiers on a distant frontier. Subsequent travels have taken me to Air Force stations and naval bases. A few weeks ago, I was privileged to fly to the Siachen Glacier. Experiencing the tough conditions there and seeing the grit and determination of the gallant soldiers and officers posted there made me very proud. With smiling faces and nerves of steel, they have kept the national flag high. All of you here will be carrying forward that remarkable legacy. The National Defense Academy is more than just a training facility. It is the crucible of valor and bravery. The fact that among its alumni are those who have been decorated with gallantry awards such as the Paramveer Chakra, the Ashok Chakra, the Mahavir Chakra, the Shaurya Chakra, and other honors bears testimony to this. The NDA has inculcated a resolve and a spirit of national service in generations of cadets and generations of officers. It is because of this heritage that in December 1978, the President's colors were conferred on the NDA. दोस्तों इसी के साथ डिक्टेशन फिनिश होती है. उम्मीद करता हूँ आप लोग अच्छे से ही लिख रहे होंगे, अच्छे से मेहनत कर रहे होंगे. लगातार आप मेहनत करते रहिए और इसी तरीके से सिलेक्शन पाते रहेंगे आप. आपसे मुलाकात करता हूँ अगली क्लास में अगले ट्रांसक्रिप्शन के साथ. तब तक के लिए बाय बाय, टेक केयर.